Hi everyone, and welcome to this episode of Fan Art Friday. In this video I'm drawing Yuta from Tokyo Ghoul, and I absolutely love working on Tokyo Ghoul fan art. I worked on a few drawings last year, and I've already worked on a couple this year. I'm so glad that a few of you suggested this drawing, as it's something that I wanted to work on for quite a long time. Thank you so much again for leaving all of your drawing suggestions in the comments, and as always, if you have any more suggestions for future videos, then please let me know in the comments below. To start off the outlines of this drawing, I used a 0.05mm sepia coloured Copic multiliner pen. It's extremely fine, and I wanted to make sure I added some dynamic looking lines to this drawing, especially adding some thicker lines around the shaded areas. So adding some thicker lines to the undersides of some parts of the hair, underneath Yuta's jawline and along his neck and that kind of thing. Changing up the thickness of the lines really helps with the final product. And it's something that I've really been trying so far this year. I've been really trying to work more on my outlining. Once I'd finished the first layer of outlining, it was time to move on to the colouring, and for the colouring of this drawing I used Copic markers. I didn't want to use too many colours for this drawing, as I wanted to focus mainly on the reds and the greys. For the colouring of his skin tones, I started off by using a light grape, and then I faded that outwards with a pale grape. And I just kept these two colours for the skin tones, I didn't use anything else, I just kept these two colours to the shaded portions of his face and underneath his neck and around that sort of area. I think leaving large portions of this drawing nice and white really helps later on, especially when I add a nice bright background colour. For the colouring of his eyes, I started off by using a cool grey number 5 as a base shade, and then I used a cool grey number 7 to add some darker shading around the outside. For the colouring of his iris, I actually used a crimson Copic marker, a nice bright red, and then I used the crimson over the top of the grey tones as well to help add that red tone overall throughout the eye. After that, I actually used a black Copic marker to add some darkness around the outlining and for the eyelashes and that kind of thing. And then finally, to add some extra highlights to the eyes, I used a Uni-ball highlighter pen. I absolutely love using this pen, especially for adding highlights to eyes and lips and that kind of thing. And then to add some final black outlines to the eyes and the eyebrows, I used a Copic multiliner pen, I think 0.3mm, and it was nice and fine to add some to sharpen up the edges around the eyes and the eyebrows. This pen really helps with the outlining, and I use it as a kind of a final bit of outlining to go over the top of some parts of the drawing. With most parts of the face and the neck coloured, it was time to move on to the hair. And I started off the base shade with a cool grey number 7, so it was nice and dark. I started off just by adding a nice layer across all of the hair, and then I started adding streaks with the same pen, just kind of building up the layers and showing different streaks and different patterns in the hair. After that, I then used a black Copic marker to add some streaks in the hair and to outline some of the outer edges and to kind of add more shape to the hair overall. And then I used the black Copic multiliner again to add some fine lines to just build up more of the layers of hair and to show some differences between the thick lines and the thin lines and build up that kind of dynamic shape. For the colouring on the shaved part of his head, I used a cool grey number 3 as the base layer, and then I used a cool grey number 5 to add some darker edges around the outside of it, and I kind of blended between them just to smoothen the shading. And following in the style of the manga, I decided to add a crosshatched line effect to the shaved part of the head. I used the black multiliner pen for this, and I think it worked quite well in distinguishing the different textures between the hair and the shaved area. And then after those lines were added, I added some highlights on the top of the head and to both sides, kind of around eye level, just to show different highlights and different lighting. Once I'd finished adding the details to the hair, I decided to start focusing on the second layer of outlining, and for that I used the black Copic multiliner pen again, and I used it to add some thick black outlines to the undersides of the face and along the neck, and just adding some thick lines to help make the character stand out overall. I also used it to add the tattoo to his neck and to add the detailing to his necklace. And then with all of that done, I decided to add a crimson background, so I added the colour within the comic panel that I previously had drawn, and I made sure to leave an outline around him. Once I'd added the crimson, I then used the Uni-ball highlighter pen again to add a highlight going all the way around Yuta and to help make him stand out from the page. I think this works especially well by having his head kind of poke out of the top of the comic panel, and then using the highlighter pen to help show him kind of standing out from that panel and to give that more kind of 3D effect of having the character stand out further from the page. As a final part of the drawing, I then used the black multiliner pen to add a thick black outline to the comic panel, and that was the drawing completed. I really hope you like this drawing, and please let me know what you think in the comments below. Thank you so much again for all of your drawing suggestions, and if you enjoy videos like this, then make sure you're subscribed. Any likes or shares in this video are hugely appreciated, and it really means a lot to me. If you want to follow me on Twitter or Facebook or Instagram and follow along with the progress photos throughout the week, then be sure to check out the links in the description box below. And once again, thank you so much for the support on this channel. It really means a lot to me, and I can't wait to work on some more drawings. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you all soon.